the third child who's battling for her life. Do we have any information on that?
Right now, when she has been moved to the hospital here, very close by here, to another private hospital. Her condition is supposed to be pretty severe, where she has also sustained some injuries because of the attacks with the machete or the knife which she has used. So she's again sustained injuries for now. Her condition not said to be critical. However, keeping in mind that she is not a very she's a very young daughter. She's one of the youngest daughters. Now this is also raises a question as to how much of bleeding she has sustained and how much of blood she has lost. Depending on this, the doctors in a short while will be able to give us the exact information, Shruti.
Now, Deepak, we also understand that Ramesh was on the run. So when was he arrested and when was a case filed against him?
The arrest happened quite some time back when immediately as soon as the people around came to know something like this happened, the police were called in. They have come and taken him to custody. When Gaurama reached this spot, she was left shattered. She spoke to the media even, but she was in no condition to actually speak. Even she was completely taken aback by what had happened. She of course knew that her husband had these kind of thoughts. He always had a problem with the daughters, but she never even assumed that he could reach down to these levels of actually taking his own daughter's lives. That's come as a shocker. She is right now left devastated. The only thing that she could do was cry, nothing else. And of course, being a mother, this is an inconsolable loss for her, Shruti. But the police have taken him into custody. They're interrogating him. But I don't know what the police can actually do about such a person who has stooped down to such lows that he has gone on to kill his own daughter, Shruti.
Well, also, Deepak, what is the neighborhood saying? What are the neighbors saying about the spouse? Were they happily married, or did they have fights among themselves which led Ramesh to take this
There are a
extreme
couple of
step?
people here. Let's try and talk to them. Neevu akka pakka maneyavaru alva akka pakka maneyavaru. Okay, but they're not willing to talk, Shruti, here. They're clearly they don't want to comment on these issues. They don't want to talk. We'll talk to one of them. Let's try and talk to one of them. Ivaru madhi aguvaga yen jagala aagtita avag ivaga adu chenagidra.
ಅದೇನಿಲ್ಲ, ಇವರು ಬಂದು ರೀಸನ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಂದಿರೋದು. ಎನಿ ಟೈಮ್ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇರೋದು, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇದೇ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ರಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದು ನಾವು. ಆ ಥರ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಇವರು. ಈಗ ಬಂದಿರೋದು ಅವರು ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಮಾತ್ರ ಒಂದು 6:30 6:57 ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಮನೆ ಓನರು ನನಗೆ, ಈ ಥರ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ನಾನು ಮಲ್ಲೇಶ್ವರಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಮಳೆ ಇದ್ದು ಮಳೆ ಬರ್ತೈತೆ, ಬರೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಹಂಗೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಅಂದರು. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಏನಾಗಿತ್ತೋ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಎರಡು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ನಾವು ಹೊಡೆದಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಣ್ಣ ಅಂತ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದರು ಓನರು. ಆ ಮನೆ ಓನರು ನಮ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಪರಿಚಯ, ಅವ್ರು ಹೋಟ್ಲು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು, ಟೀ ಕಾಫಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ರು.
ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀವು ಬೇರೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ, ಏನಾದ್ರೆ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಬಂತಾ, ಏನಾದ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಳು ಕಿರ್ಚ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ, ಏನಾದ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ?
ನಮಗೂ ಮನೆಗೆಲ್ಲ ದೂರ, ಆ ಕಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮನೆಗೆ ನಮ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ದೂರ, ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಆ ಕಡೆ ಇರೋದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ.
ನೀವೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ ಅವ್ರ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಕಿರ್ಚ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಏನಾದ್ರೆ?
ಸರ್, ಏನ್ ಕಿರ್ಚ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು ಅಂತಾನೆ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಅವರು ಕೆಳಗಡೆಯಿಂದ ಮೇಲಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿರೋದು ಓನರು. ಸೊ ಓನರ್ ಹೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾತಾಡಿರೋದು. ಸೊ ಓನರ್ ಹೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ಓನರ್ನ ತಳ್ಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ತಳ್ಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಡೋರ್ ಲಾಕ್ ಹಾಕಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಡೋರ್ ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ತದಕ್ಕೆ ತಡೆದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೂಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಓನರು. ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ನು ನೋಡೋಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಅವಾಗ ಇವ್ರು ತೆಗೆದು ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇದು ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಸರ್.
ಇವರು ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ, ಅವ್ರ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಹೇಗಿತ್ತು? ಅವ್ರ ಮಚ್ಚ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅವ್ರನ್ನೂ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು, ಅಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಬಂತು.
ಪೊಲೀಸ್ನವರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ನವ್ರು ಹಿಡಿಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವನು ಓಡೋಗಿದ್ದಾನು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲ ಜನಗಳ ಮಧ್ಯ ಕುಂತಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕತ್ತಲ್ ಕುಂತಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ ಒಂದು 3/4 ಅವರ್ ಕುಂತಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಜನ ನೋಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಪಕ್ಕದ ಮನೆಯದು ಒಬ್ಬ ಅಜ್ಜಿ, ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸರ್ ಇವನೇ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ಅವನ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಜನ ಹೋಗಿ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದಾಗ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ನವರು ಅವನ್ನ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸರ್. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇದು ಫುಲ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಅವನ್ಗೆ, ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇವನ್ಗೆ ತಾತ ಅವ್ರ ಅಪ್ಪನ್ಗೆ. ಸೊ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ
ಖರ್ಚಿ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದ ಹೇಗೆ
ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಟ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಸರ್ ಇಷ್ಟು, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಗೋಡೆಗೂ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಇಷ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್.
ಧರಣಿ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಮೂರನೇ ಮಗು, ಅವಳು ಇನ್ನೂ ಬದುಕಿದಾಳೆ, ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೆ. ಅವ್ರ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನೀವು ಹೊಡೆದ್ರೆ ಹೇಗಿದ್ರು?
ಈಗ
ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏಳು ಒಂದ್ ಹೊಡೆದು ಒಂದ್ 15-20 ನಿಮಿಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದ್ರು ಸರ್. ಸೊ ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಅವ್ರದ್ದೇನು ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
So there you go, Shruti. They're saying that this man clearly, once he committed the crime, he apparently ran away from the house again, came back and sat among these people. The cops actually didn't know who it was. Then one of the ladies here in the neighborhood houses actually informed the cops that this was the person. He apparently had tied a handkerchief around his forehead where he had also cut himself near his head. That's what the neighbors here claim. And they also claim that Dharani, the third daughter, who has managed to escape this assault, has managed to escape with fewer injuries and no real threat to her life. That's what they are claiming, Shruti.
Well, also, Deepak, tell us, what is the police saying at this point in time?
The police right now have arrested him. They've taken him to the Byatarli police station. The interrogation is happening currently there. We will be shortly heading there, Shruti, to get the updates. As of now, the interrogation is on. They have arrested him. Now, first of all, they will be giving him some medical treatment as he has also sustained injuries and probably will not be in a condition to be subjected to a proper form of interrogation now. So that will probably be the next step of the police, where they will try to stabilize him, stop the bleeding, and then probably go ahead with the interrogation. For now, the police have left the spot. None of the officials are currently here, Shruti.
So is he being given any kind of medical treatment at this point in time? You just told us that he was injured, that he had tied a handkerchief to his head. He had an injury on his forehead. So is he being given any kind of medical treatment at this point in time?
Of course, Shruti, that is usually the procedure whenever, even though he's the person who was assaulted, he's the one who's committed the crime. But before interrogating him, they will make sure that he is his bleeding or his medical condition is stable before they start actually interrogating him. So before that, the police usually do not subject them to interrogation. But here, they must have asked him a few questions. They will record a few statements in the hospital. It depends on the kind of injuries, Shruti, because as soon as the police have got hold of him. They have taken him to the police station. So we do not understand the gravity of the injuries that he has sustained. So depending on that, they will be subjecting him to interrogation. Injuries are pretty severe. They will record a small statement first, and then they will go about the interrogation once he has reached a pretty stable condition. Until
right.
then, they will make sure that
right.
He reaches a pretty stable condition, Shruti.
Right. Deepak, we'll put you on hold there. We have the owner of the residence.
ಗೋವಿಂದಪ್ಪ ಹೇಳಿ ಗೋವಿಂದಪ್ಪ ಏನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಆಯ್ತು ಗೋವಿಂದಪ್ಪ ಸಾಯಂಕಾಲ
ಸರ್ ನಾನು ಆಫೀಸ್ ಕೆಲ್ಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ನಾನು ನಮ್ ಬರೋದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ನಮ್ಮನೇರು ನಾನು ಆರೂವರೆ ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್ ಬರೋದು ಆಫೀಸ್ ಹತ್ರನೇ ಇದ್ದೆ ಅಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಈ ತರ ಮನೇಲಿ ಅವ್ರ ಅಪ್ಪ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನ ಮೂರ್ ಜನನು ಕೊಚ್ಚಿ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಬೇಗ ಬಾ ಅಂದ್ರು ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಕೊಚ್ಚ ಪಕ್ಕದ ಮನೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದೀವಿ ಆ ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಅವರು ಆಂಟಿ ಅವ್ರ ಅಪ್ಪ ಹುಡುಗಿಯರ್ನ ಮಚ್ಚಾಂಡು ಒಳಗೆ ಹೋದ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿರಂತೆ
ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇವಾಗ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ
ಹೌದು ಸರ್
ಅದು ಮೂರನೇ ಮಗಳು ಹೆಂಗಿದ್ದಾಳೆ ಅವಳು
ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್
ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅವಳಿಗೆ
ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಅದೇ ಗದ್ದ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ತುಟ್ಟಿಯಿಂದ ಕೆಳಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು 3 ಇಂಚು ಕೊಯ್ದಂಗಾಗಿದೆ ಕಿವಿ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಏಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ
ಹೌದಾ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ವಾ ಈ ತರ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ವಾ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್
ಯಾರು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು
ಮನೆಯವರು ಸರ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯವರು ಹೆಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತು
ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು
ನಾನು ಆಫೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ನ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ನೀವು ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರು ಇದ್ರ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರ ಮಗಳು ಅವ್ರ ಹುಡುಗಿರು ಅಪ್ಪ ಇದ್ರ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ
ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಬೀಗ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಓಡೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಂತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯವ್ರು ಬೀಗ ಕಿತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬೀಗ ತೆಗೆದು ನೋಡಿರದಂತೆ
ರೈಟ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಗೋವಿಂದಪ್ಪ well, that was Govindappa, the owner of the house, who said he had got information that from his house people, from his family members, that his tenant had attacked 3 of his daughters, and he was at the hospital, and he says that the third daughter, who is injured, is recovering now, and she's not in there's no serious injuries, but he says she's recovering and she's fine. And he says he had got information that that his tenant had attacked 3 of his daughters, and that was how he learned about the incident. Well, Deepak, if you can hear me, Deepak, the owner of the house says that he was not around. In fact, he learnt about the incident, and he has gone to the hospital now. Who exactly informed him about the whole incident, and who informed the police, Deepak?
Yeah, the neighbors say that first they heard the owner of the house was whom called one of the neighbors here and told them such a thing has happened. I clearly don't understand here. I just spoke to one of the residents here who stays very close by. He informed us that the owner of the house was one who had informed them that such an incident had happened. That's when they went on top to see all of this drama unfold. By this time, they claim that Ramesh had already left the house, and about 45 minutes he was missing. And then when the people had gathered, the police had come, they still didn't know who the culprit was. That's when he had come back, and that's when one of the grandmothers near the house has identified this man who was sitting among the people here, Michael. He was sitting among the people with a handkerchief tied around his head as he was bleeding profusely from the head because he had also assaulted himself. Maybe it was guilt that he killed his own daughters which made him take such a step, Michael, that he had to actually assault himself with the same weapon that he used to kill his two daughters.
What exactly is the condition of the mother, Deepak, at the moment?
She is absolutely devastated, Michael. Speaking to her some time back, she had no words to say. Of course, she's inconsolable losing two of her daughters. She still does not understand how her third daughter is. She's in no condition right now to even speak to the media properly. We tried to talk to her, but of course, it was really terrible moments, like trying to talk to her. She couldn't just control her tears, Michael. She didn't know what to say. She did not understand why her husband, the father of the two children, how he could take such a drastic step and actually assault and actually go about killing two of his daughters and actually almost the third daughter as well. So she's left completely devastated. She does not know how to go about this. She does not know how to handle it right now. She as well will probably need some medical treatment with the kind of trauma that she has undergone, Michael.